Once a CalderaRIP license has been purchased, the license information will be provided. Two options are then possible. The codes can be sent directly to the end user. Or it can be sent to the partner handling the installation. In any case, the customer license must always be registered with their own WorkSpace account. Three elements are required when activating CalderaRIP. An access number. An activation code. And a fingerprint file. The access number is a unique number per license and is made up of 6 digits. This number is sent by email after the purchase. The activation code is a 20-digit code, which is also sent by email. The fingerprint is a small file that needs to be generated from the RIP station to activate. To generate the fingerprint, CalderaDoc must be used. From the Licenses tab, click on CalderaRIP. Then click on Export Fingerprint. You then choose a destination folder. The default folder is Downloads. Finally, click the Export button to generate the fingerprint. It will generate a C2V file that will be used later during license registration in WorkSpace. As explained earlier, the license must be registered from the end user's WorkSpace account. To do so, we go to Downloads and Install area. Then click on Caldera Licenses Management. This can also be done by going to the User Settings, My Registered License, Register a New License. Here, you type the access number. Then type the activation code. Next, it is required to assign the printers. The options displayed here depend on the category and the number of printers which are included with the license. Here, for instance, the customer purchased 3 drivers, so 3 slots are available. 2 slots for large drivers, and 1 slot for a Grand B driver. At this step, you must assign the printer manufacturer and specific printer model to each slot. After the first assignment, the customer has 7 days to modify it if any errors are made. Note that after the 7-day timeframe, this option is no longer available. However, a printer can be left unassigned. After the license registration, assigning a printer can be done at any time as needed. Once the printers are assigned, we click on Continue. We are asked to upload the fingerprint file exported earlier from CalderaDoc. This action will attach the license to a specific computer, meaning it will not be possible to use the license on another device, unless the license is rehosted on a new fingerprint. We click Continue to register the license. The new registered license is then added to the customer's account, visible from the My Licenses tab. You must now download the license file. To do so, click on the Download button visible in the Action area. Here, 2 options are available. You can either download a V2C activation file or a V2CP license update package. The license update is required when the RIP station is not connected to the internet and the license cannot be updated automatically. As we are doing a new CalderaRIP activation, we must download an activation file. By default, the destination folder is the download folder, whether you are working on Linux or Mac OS. It is time to activate the CalderaRIP. The V2C activation file must be applied with CalderaDoc. From the License tab, click on Apply License File. Choose the V2C file that we downloaded previously. Then click the Apply button. Now the license has been successfully added to the system. Let's launch CalderaRIP. As you can see, CalderaRIP is not activated yet. Therefore, we need to attach the license. To do so, click on Configure License. Then click on Manage License. Here you can see that the license already appears in the list. So, you need to select the license and click the Attach button. Finally, you close the windows to apply changes. CalderaRIP is now activated.